you in your struggles for worker justice as a former worker and organizing?
Yeah, I'll just give a brief history for those who don't know me. My name is Colby Harris. I'm an organizer in training now through the AFL. I was a worker at Walmart for 4 years up until October 30th last year. I was fired for participating in ULP strikes and being involved in that lime green shirt that young man's wearing. Al Walmart, which is an organization that the workers formed 4 years ago to basically call on our company, well, their company, to change and to give the workers what they deserve, treat them better, give them a livable wage, and, you know, just be a good company as a whole. And as far as how my faith relates to that, I actually joined our Walmart 2 years ago, and a lot of our good friends, his name is Terry Dunn. He was actually the organizer working for USCW, who I met while working at Walmart, who introduced me to the organization. And I can remember it vividly like it was yesterday. It was the beginning of June 2 years ago in 2012, and Terry came to me because I was having some issues inside of my store, just seeing other people go through things. I was one of the more privileged associates, I would say. I was still a low-wage worker working at Walmart, so nobody's doing too well, but I did have 40 hours a week, had weekends off, so I was pretty much better off than a lot of people that were in there were getting 20-something hours, scraping by week. But I got really agitated just seeing other workers go through things, struggling with getting consistent schedules to take care of their children, people just not have enough money to get lunch for the next day or having enough gas to get to work to get paid. You know, and those things just really frustrated me because I feel like I'm not living for me. You know, if you really live in life, you're living it to better everybody else's life. You know, I think the best way to actually be a selfish person is to care about everybody else. If you really want to be selfish, you know, but when I met Terry, we had a conversation because I had met him through an associate who had joined the organization a few weeks prior to me, who no longer even is there anymore. But Terry, we sat down and talked in his car for about 20 minutes, and the first thing he said was, this guy's got something for you, you know, but you got to get active and move. And that was that serenaded me so quick and just, it laid in me. And I told him, I said, I am a person of faith, but I don't really know too much about this organization, but what I'll do is I'll pray tonight, and tomorrow when I get off of work, I'll call you and I'll have an answer if I want to join up. Of course, as you all know, I ended up joining the organization and it really changed my life. You know, I really feel like I can't say I'm a person of faith if I'm not standing up for the poor people, because Jesus' whole life was about, he didn't even have a place to lay his head. He didn't even have a home, you know, so I cannot say that I'm living my life if I'm not trying to better somebody else's, and that for me helped me get through, especially when I got fired. The day I got fired, I worked all the way up until 10 minutes before my shift ended. I worked 5 to 2 in produce. And at this point, I'd already participated in 4 or 5 ULP strikes against the company for them retaliating against us for having an organization trying to better ourselves. And so they called me to the office the last day and basically said, hey, you know, we're going to have to let you go due to absenteeism. You know, you've missed a certain amount of days and, you know, from all of, they never said that we're fighting for protesting because that would have been a labor charge and it probably would have been put me on TV again. But at the same time, you know, I was sitting in there smiling and the managers were looking at me crazy. You know, I'm in there, my store manager's in there, and there's two other managers in there just looking at me like, you know, why isn't he overreacting? Why is he getting angry? You know, we're firing him for protesting, for standing up for workers, and he's not mad or agitated. I smiled, you know, nodded my head, said, okay. They walked me out, all the managers, about 6 people, you know, and the store's packed. You know, so they're trying to basically follow me out of the store in front of everybody because they know I was an activist in the store. Everybody know I was a part of our Walmart protesting, still for workers' rights. But they tried to embarrass me and chauffeur me out, you know, and kind of basically show the workers, hey, here's that guy that, you know, is a part of our Walmart doing all this striking. Now we're getting rid of him, you know, trying to make an example out of me. And so we get to the door, and I turned around, and they said, well, Kobe, you can leave. I said, you know what, you guys have a great day, and thank you. And I shook all their hands and gave them hugs. He looked at me crazy like, we just fired you for protesting illegally and you're not mad about it? And the reason why I wasn't mad is because my thing is this. If we're really going to change Walmart, we have to pray for them. We have to understand that they need a savior too, just like anybody else. You know, so I really like what Joerg said earlier about how the fact that we're all going to end up in the same place if we don't understand that they're not the enemy. They might not have an understanding. The Watsons don't have an understanding. So we have to pray for them and let God know that we care about them too. You know, it's not a us against them thing. We want them to change to the point to where their hearts are convicted. You know, they can change all the policies, give us $25K a year, give us affordable health care and benefits, but if their hearts haven't changed, is it going to stay like that?
No.
Probably not. You know, so I think it's when it comes to me and my faith, that's the main thing that I lean on. You know, I don't even wake up without faith. I go to sleep with it. You know, you can't live without faith. You can think you're living, but you're really just, you're existing. You know, but I want to live, and the only way to live is to care about others through God. I'm still struggling. I'm not perfect, and last time I checked, nobody in here is. But when you realize that is when you can really move forward, you know, and really do God's work the way it needs to be done. So thank you for hearing me and having us here. And if you don't have strong faith, please do, because it will really help. And that's what I lean on a daily basis.